All right, this is Pastor Lupe Sanchez, Jesus Lord Baptist Church. We invite you for services this Sunday at 11 o'clock, LMS Building, 3800 Hopper Road at 11 o'clock. Hope you can make it. We'll be in the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 13, verse 1. Paul says, though I speak with tongues of men and of angels, and have not charity, I become as sounding brass or tinkling cymbal. Paul told the church, he said, if I could speak like Elijah or Elisha or Moses or even one of the angels, Michael, and if I have no charity, and charity is basically love in action, then my words have no effect. When I speak, I make noise. I sound like brass or tinkling cymbals. Paul's basically saying, what good is it if I have the perfect sermon or the perfect speech or the perfect lesson? If I don't have charity, if there's no charity there, it is worthless. It is worthless. It's just a bunch of words. There's no touch from heaven. God's not in it. We just can't have the right words to say to somebody and tell them about the cross and tell them about Christ dying for us. We also have to have love in action. That's charity. Charity. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all the mysteries and knowledge, and though I have faith so that I could remove mountains and have not charity, I am nothing. Paul tells the church again, if I could prophesy, tell you what's fixing to happen in the future, be able to tell you things that are going to happen this week, next year, 10 years from now. He said, even if I could do that and let you know all these things, plus be able to have the faith to move to a, tell to a mountain, you know, move a little bit to the left, move a little bit to the right, move a little forward, move a little backwards. No matter what I told, and I could able to do this, if I had this power and not a touch of charity, it is worthless. Worthless. Though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, though I give my body to be burned and have not charity, it profiteth me nothing. Paul again tells us, I could sell everything I had, all my possessions, my vehicles, my home, empty out my bank account, give every dollar to the poor, go live under a bridge. He said, or even if I went even further and I sacrificed myself and let me be burnt for others, if it doesn't have a touch of charity, love and action, it is worthless. Worthless. Why? Well, verse 4, charity suffereth long, is kind. Charity envieth not. Charity vaunteth not itself, it is not puffed up. Love and action, charity, suffers a long time, a long time. So God's people, when they're filled with charity, they can put up with a lot. They can put up with a lot of people that rub them in the wrong way. Now, if you never had anybody rub you in the wrong way, or you just couldn't stand this individual for whatever reason, somebody talking about you and they get under your skin, somebody gossiping or wants to hurt you, charity says, let's love them a little bit longer. Let's try to help them out a little bit longer. Let's pray for them a little bit longer. You can't do that without charity. Without charity and God, amen, putting charity in you, that love and action, people will not understand this. Why are you putting up with these people? I mean, these people are the ones that are trying to hurt you, trying to talk bad about you. Why do you continue loving them? And it's because of the touch of God, because of charity. Charity envieth not. Love in action. That's what it is. Charity. It doesn't want what others have. Charity is satisfied with its portion. Charity vaunteth not itself, is not puffed up. Charity doesn't go around, look at me, look at what I've done. Look what I'm doing for the Lord. That's not what charity does. Charity doth not behave itself unseemingly, seeketh not her own, is not easily provoked, thinketh no evil. Charity keeps a sober approach to life. You're not going to hear some off-the-wall thing from charity. Charity is going to be very serious when it comes to the gospel. Charity is going to tell you the way to heaven. It's not going to say, well, you know, when somebody asks you a question, which way is to heaven? You're going to tell them the truth. There's only one way. It doesn't matter whether they're a Muslim. It doesn't matter if they're a Buddhist or whatever. Charity is going to tell the truth and do it with kind, loving words. That's what charity is going to do. It keeps itself sober. Charity is never going to try to promote itself. What can I get out of this? It's not going to try to influence others and try to figure out, well, you know, if I can get them in the church, this is going to help my business. If I can do this, it's going to help. Charity's not that way. Charity, love and action, is not looking out for what can I get out of this? What can I get out of this relationship? What can I get out of the church? What can I get from somebody else? That's not charity. Charity, it's hard to provoke charity. It's not easily provoked. When confronted, charity says, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to offend you. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that. Charity is not easily provoked. I know some people, I mean, they got buttons all over them. I mean, you just look at them, and their little buttons already, it's already been pushed. You don't even have to do anything. You don't have to get near them. They just look at you from across the room, and they think, you know, you must be talking bad about me. And they're already upset just because you might have laughed somewhere, you know, in the same room, and they're on the other side, and the next thing you know, you are self-conscious, and you're thinking, well, they must be talking about me. Charity doesn't do that. Charity is not easily provoked. Charity doesn't think evil. It doesn't want revenge. It doesn't want murder. It doesn't want to get back at that person that hurt you. Charity doesn't do that. Charity rejoiceth not in iniquity, but rejoices in truth. Again, charity is love and action. It's not going to rejoice or brag about the sins it's done. A person that's filled with charity is not going to talk about the sins they've done. You know, I committed adultery, I stole, I did this, I did that. Charity's not going to do that. Charity is never going to do that. It's never going to rejoice or brag about its sin. Charity rejoices in truth. You say, what's the truth? That's the Bible. That's preaching. That's what charity is. Charity, it rejoices in truth. When's the last time you read your Bible and you just went, wow, look how at this verse right here, how God's speaking to my heart, how God's trying to lead me and guide me and show me what I ought to do. That's what charity does. When a person's filled with charity, they're looking at that Bible. It doesn't matter what it says, whether thou shalt not or whether God so loved the world. It makes no difference. Charity loves all truth. It loves that Bible. It loves to hear when a preacher gets up and actually preaches the truth. Even if it stomps on their toes, charity says, I rejoice. I rejoice in the truth. Charity beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, endureth all things. Again, charity's love and action will go along. Even if you know it won't come to pass, it beareth all things. It just bears it. I remember one time my pastor told me, he said, we're going to help this little church out, and I want you to help him. And I went, yeah, but that pastor's a nut. I said, that guy, he ain't going to make it. I said, why in the world do I want to help this guy? Why are we trying? Why are we even bothering? You know it ain't going to work. You know this guy's not going to build up work. He said, well, He said, I don't want to stand before God and have to tell God we didn't try. That's what charity does. It looks at somebody and says, listen, there's not much hope there, but I'm going to try to be a blessing to them. I'm going to try to help them. I know they may never get saved. I'm going to keep praying for them. I'm going to still keep witnessing to them. I'm still going to keep inviting them to church. I'm going to do everything I can. That's what charity does. It beareth it all. It beareth it all. It believeth all. It believes God is still working. When you pray for somebody, say, Lord, would you please save them? And then nothing happens. Charity believes God is actually working in that person's heart, is actually trying to do something. And whether we see it or not, we actually just believe it. I prayed. I told God this is what I wanted. I believe it. And charity believeth all. God's going to do something for them. Whether they accept the gospel or not, I do know this. My loving God hears my prayers, and He's going to speak to their heart. That's what charity does. That's what charity does. Charity beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things. There are some situations, I mean, there's just no hope. I remember these two ladies, they just couldn't get along. I said, listen, all you can do is live for God. If you'll live for God, and God wants this relationship to grow, I said, God will get in there. It went an hour later, and I had no hope. I mean, I thought this was way at the bottom. But I said what God told me to say. It went an hour later. They was hugging. They was crying. They was talking to each other. Charity, love and action. It hoping. I'm hoping everything will work out. There are some things in my life I would love to see. I would love for God to just touch some folks. I'm just hoping God will do it. Charity hopeth. It hopeth all things. It endureth all things. You know what enduring means? Putting up. You're enduring some things. Sometimes it's a mate. Sometimes it's your children. Sometimes it's those around you. Sometimes it's a situation. You know what charity does? It says, by and by, we're going to get through this. We're going to get through this. This virus is going along. Hey, charity just endureth and says, hey, this is just something we got to go through. We're going to make it. We're going to make it. That's love in action. You got to have charity. You got to have charity. Charity wants every soul to go to heaven. Charity wants all souls to get right with God. Charity wants everybody to be in love, madly in love with the Lord Jesus Christ, with the church, with their Bible, so they actually want to do something for God. That's what charity does. Charity says, hey, this is what I want. Charity beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, endureth all things. You can tell a man or a woman that has charity. Nothing in the world can stop them. It doesn't matter if somebody's lying to them, lying about them. It doesn't matter if somebody's making fun of them. It doesn't matter if somebody's trying to hurt them. You know what charity does? It's just, I'm just going to keep on going for the Lord. I love the Lord, and I'm just going to keep going. And those people that want to hurt me, I'm just going to keep praying for them. Paul said, he said, some preach, amen, to bring trouble to me. He says, others preach out of love. He said, but there's some. All they want to do is cause me pain. He said, it don't matter. The gospel's still going out. That's a man that's got charity. He don't care how it works out. He doesn't care. I don't care if they're preaching bad about me. Makes no difference. As long as the gospel gets out, that's the main thing. As long as God is trying, amen, is still trying to get the gospel out, it don't matter if they're talking bad about me. Charity. Charity. Charity never failed. I guess the best illustration would be, we used to have a gentleman used to go to church with. His name was Carl Wright. Carl Wright, I tell you, he was a good man. And he'd come up to you, and he'd shake your hand. He'd converse with you. He'd make you feel like you was his lost son. You was his lost daughter. I mean, this man just loved to come over there. He'd give you a firm handshake. He was just the kind of guy that just loved being there. He was a church greeter. That's somebody that's got charity. They love everybody. They just love everybody. Another one would be Miss Sides. Miss Sides, she'd take a big bowl of soup and she'd go out to the ghetto and she'd tell them kids a Bible story. She'd feed them. She'd make sure everybody got fed. She'd make sure everybody knew some scripture. You say, why? Charity. Charity to love. That's love in action. Charity. Let me ask you this. Does anybody see any charity in you? Do they see charity, love, and action in you? Do they see Christ in you? I mean, these folks, you could tell. They had charity. They had charity. Charity never failing. It never fails. But whether they be prophecy, they shall fail. No. Prophesying ended. When the Bible was completed, it ended. Where there be tongues, they shall cease. No more talking in tongues. Where there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. I mean, sometimes I get to praying and I'm saying, now, Lord, I want you to, I need you to pray for so-and-so, and I've already forgotten who their mate was. I mean, the knowledge has just gone out of my mind. I can't even remember the person I'm supposed to. I know who it is. I just can't say their name. You say, why? Knowledge, it shall vanish away. Tongues shall they cease, where they be knowledge, it shall vanish away. All that's going to end. Prophecy, tongues, knowledge, but not charity. Charity never faileth. Charity just keeps on going and going and going. That's love in action. Do you have that? You got that love in action? Charity never failed. The Lord Jesus Christ was the greatest preacher, teacher, healer, prophet that ever lived. He taught us over and over while he was in this life that we ought to love, that we need love. He showed it when he was willing to die on Calvary. Between them two thieves, shed his blood. I mean, he looked like hamburger meat as much as they had beaten him. Love in action. You know, you can always tell when you're cold on God. When you're looking at the cross, and you're looking at the cross, and it doesn't make you more in love with the Lord. Your love has gone cold. Your charity has gone cold. When you can't look at that cross and say, now, Lord, I sure appreciate it. You don't have any type of emotion for the cross. Jesus, when somebody gets talking about Calvary, if that doesn't affect you at all, your love has gone real cold on God. Charity. Charity. The Lord proved it. He proved it on Calvary. You say, where did Jesus get that? Well, he got it from the Father. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, whoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. God loved the world. Jesus was willing to pay the price because they loved us. Even knowing that most would reject the gospel, even knowing all this, love and action, charity continue. You know, that's what the world's looking for. They're looking for love. And as Baptists, especially Independent Fundamental Baptists, the one thing we're not known for is our love. We're known for our lack of love, but not our love. Sometimes we have the worst reputation of being an unloving denomination. I can say this. There's times we just don't need no more preaching. And we don't need no more teaching. And we don't need no more singing. We don't need no more prayer. What we need is charity. We need somebody to be able to see Christ in us through the love in action and how we treat others, how we speak of Christ. That's what we need. We need charity. We need charity. Paul said, who cares how great of a Christian you are if you don't have charity? Baptists have all the right answers. We got the right Bible. We got the King James 1611. We got the right doctrine. We believe in the premillennial. We got the right convictions. A man ought to be a man. A woman ought to be a woman. But what good is all that without charity? You have got to have charity. Without charity, everything else is worthless. Everything else doesn't amount to anything. You got to have charity. Somebody comes and visits the church and they look like the world and looks like they've been handicapped by the world. They got the marks all over them. I mean, they've been beat up all over by the world. And we stare at them and we think, stay away from my daughter. Stay away from my son. That's not the way we're supposed to treat people. It's supposed to make them feel them at home. They're supposed to be able to see charity in the church. Somebody ought to be able to be like Brother Carl and greet them and shake their hand and tell them, boy, we sure appreciate you coming. And man, gonna be praying for you. And, I mean, get involved in their life. Charity. Charity. You gotta have charity. That's how you treat somebody else. And just stare at them and, make them feel like they're wanted, like, on some milk carton or at the post office. I wonder how much they're worth. No, that's not the way it's supposed to be. You're supposed to treat people with some charity. Charity. Your job as a Christian is not to tell them what they can do, what they can't do. You're not supposed to tell them how they're supposed to dress and all the rules and regulations. They got a Bible. They can read it themselves. All they got to do is get the New Testament. It's not your job. Your job is to love them. That is charity. Love in action. Don't just tell me you love them. I want some action. Show me. Show me that you care about these folks. Show me that you care about one another. That's what God wants. He wants charity. I'll say this. Sinners are supposed to get... go out on the town Saturday night. They're supposed to do the things that sinner does. They're supposed to smoke, chase women. Leave them alone. As long as they show up on Sunday, and one Sunday, hopefully they'll decide, I'm either going to get back in the world and continue my life, or I want to get born again. I'm sick and tired of this old life. Your job is to keep praying for them. Your job is to keep loving them. Your job is to tell them, hey, they got a place here in the church. That's what our job is. Sinners, man, all you're supposed to do is love them. You're not supposed to give them a bunch of rules and regulations throwing on them. You let God do His work. God will work on their heart and their soul and their mind, and God can straighten somebody else. But it takes charity, love in action from each and every one of us. You're part of the church, you got to love them. Your job is to love them just the way you are. Ain't that the way we want people to love us? To respect us? To look at us? We want others to love us. That's the way we ought to do with sinners. That's the way we ought to do with one another in the church. We just need to love them just the way they are. Let God work on them. If you don't have charity, you need to get some charity. Get you some. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. That's what the Lord said, 1 John 4:11. You say, who should we love? Well, everybody, including the religious bunch. I remember Brother Randy used to have a church up in Utah. He's got one in Porter now. And he'd win all them Mormons to the Lord up in Utah. That's all it was Mormon land. You say, how do you win them? Charity, love in action, someone showing them love, the love of God in their life, being kind to them. Houston is full of lonely people that are looking for somebody to love them. I mean, you can look at some women. I mean, they'll have tattoos in certain positions of their body, and all they want is attention. Please look at me. Even if it's the wrong kind of attention, they want attention. They want somebody. Please look at me. I mean, they'll put all kinds of stuff. They'll fix up their hair a certain way. They'll look like the world and talk like the world because they want somebody to look at them and pay attention. As Christians, that's what we ought to do. We ought to, amen, love them. Houston, I mean, it's full of cities, lonely people, religious people, Baptists, Catholics, Jehovah's Witness, Mormons. They're all looking for somebody to love them. People look for love in all kinds of wrong places, bars and gangs and broken relationships and religion. And we as a church ought to be a lighthouse to show them charity, love and action. They need to be able to see that. There's something different about us. There's something different about us. Jesus loved you. He died for you. I mean, what more can he do to show you his love? We're supposed to be called Christians. That means we're supposed to act like Christ. Be Christ-like. We're supposed to love. We're supposed to love. I mean, he hung on that cross and he said, Father, forgive them. They don't even know what they're doing. He didn't get upset. He still loved them. He still loved them. Jesus taught us how to love. Even to the point where Judas, even though he was a thief, a hypocrite, a traitor, eventually turned him in for money. You know what the Lord called him? He still called him a friend. He said, you're my friend. I'm telling you, you can tell when a person has charity. They still love you even though you're fixing to stab them in the back. And they already know it. I know you're going to stick me. They still have love in action. That's the lovely Lord Jesus Christ. Even though knowing everything Judas was going to do, betray him, he still called him friend. Man, you got that kind of charity? You have that kind of charity? That love in action? I give you another. When Paul got to preaching, before he became Paul, he was out there rounding up Christians, torturing them, locking them up in prison, making them blaspheme the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And there you are going to church, and this guy has killed your mama, your dad, one of your children, your aunt, your uncle. He gets up to preach. You gonna get anything out of it? I mean, you ever gone to a service and you don't like the preacher? You just can't stand the preacher. The Lord chose Paul for a reason. He chose him because he knew he was going to be able to go out there and just endure all that hardness and just keep on going, serving the Lord. He also knew what others were going to do. They were going to have to look at Paul, and they were going to have to make up their mind. Am I going to ask some charity? Because, Lord, this is a lot of charity for me to get something out of a man that hurt my family. Would you please help me? The Lord chose Paul to get his message out. He chose him. Why? So that we could be the Christian that we ought to be. Filled with charity. Filled with charity. Without charity, we have nothing. You can't have a good testimony without charity. You gotta have charity. Paul said, what good is it to move mountains, give all your money to the poor, sacrifice your body? What good is it? You gotta have charity. You can't get charity out of the Bible, out of the church, from God. You can't get it out of Calvary, at the cross. You better find a way to get some charity, because you're going to need it. You're going to need, some of you need to just stop being a grouch, stop being bitter, stop being a sourpuss, and get you some charity, some love and action. Well, I stand for this and I stand, who cares? Who really cares about all that? Is it helping anybody get saved? Is anybody helping anybody to get closer to the Lord? You gotta have charity. Some of y'all just need to stop being a super Christian and get you some charity. Yes, you can have convictions. You can have grace and mercy, forgiveness. But you need charity. You need that love in action. I believe in convictions. I believe, amen, you ought to try to live for God the way God tells you through the Bible, through the New Testament. I believe that 100%. But at the same time, you better have some charity. You need charity. Again, the definition of a Christian is being Christ-like. When they see your life, who do they see? Do they see Christ? Do they see Jesus in your life? Or do they see some Pharisee's life? John 15:12, this is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Is your life full of love that they can see the love of the Father in your life? Or when they see your life, do they see some angry God with a 2x4 ready for them to be beaten over the head for something they've done? That's what most people think of. I think God's in heaven with a 2x4. Ready to hit them over the head. You know what they need? They need somebody with charity to tell them, no, God loves you. God cares about you. He sent his son to die for you. You know, they need somebody, amen, to be able to tell the gospel and tell them about Christ. I wonder how many more souls we could win when we witness. If we had a tear in our eyes, we had a broken heart, we had a word of encouragement, and we had charity. I wonder how many folks would get saved. A lot of times, we get to talking to somebody and they disagree with us. Next thing you know, we just want to start some kind of argument. But a soft answer turneth away wrath. We'd rather, tell them, it's either Jesus or you're going to hell. I mean, just that quick. And there is a hell. I'm telling you, you win a whole lot more souls if you had a little honey. If you put a little honey in your witnessing, people would come to know Christ a whole lot better. We need charity. Charity is what's going to take to win lost family and lost friends to Christ. Charity is going to take, that's what it's going to take to win neighbors and friends. Charity. Aren't you glad somebody cared about you, prayed for you, shed a tear for you, witnessed to you, invited you to church, and had some charity? They cared about you, willing to even be made fun of because they were going to tell you about the gospel. We need charity. Sinners, they don't care about it. Well, you're going to have peace and joy. Okay. Well, Jesus died. Okay. You're going to have eternal life if you go to, if you get saved. Okay. You know what sinners want? They want somebody to love them. They need somebody to take part of their life. I don't know how many folks we've tried. And I remember this one lady, she just looked at me. She said, you really care about us, don't you? I said, yeah. She said, why don't you just get in the van? She got in the van. That's what it takes. It takes charity. Somebody's got to be able to see that in your life. That you really care about their soul. I mean, I know what sinners do. They're looking for every kind of way, any kind of love that they can get. But the only true love they're going to get is through Christ. And the only way they're going to see that is through you. We need charity. Storms of life are gonna come, they're gonna go. work, home, church, family. The only way you're going to survive is with charity. That's love and action. Love and action. As an independent fundamental Baptist, we don't hardly ever get along with ourselves. I mean, we're always talking about this doctrine or that doctrine. I mean, somebody's always want to talk about something else. But what you need is charity. Charity. I mean, we love to argue. Sometimes I argue with myself. I mean, sometimes I don't even agree with my own doctrine. We just love to argue. But what we need more than anything else is love and action, charity. What kind of reputation do you have? What kind of reputation does your family have? What kind of reputation does the church have? Is it charity? Is that what they say when they see you and your family? They really care about me. I mean, they care. They're nuts, but they care about me. I was talking about that Jesus guy, but I can tell they really love me. That's what charity does. That's what charity does. Do you have charity in your life? Can others see that charity in your life? We need charity. We need charity. Maybe you ought to just pray and say, Lord, I don't have that love and action. I got a line. When people pass this line, that's it. I'm through with it. Done. Charity endureth all. It just keeps on loving. Even when somebody does you wrong. Even when they stab you in the back, I'm just going to keep praying for them. I'm just going to keep loving them. I'm going to have a count. I'm not going to get no argument. I'm just going to keep loving them. Charity. That's the kind of thing that you can't buy at Walmart. You can't win it at the lottery. The only way you get that charity is you got to ask God. Would you please help me, Lord, get some charity in me? Would you fill me? Fill me with the Holy Ghost. Get me right with you. Because I'd like to be that kind of Christian. Somebody that can tell that person really loves. They really have some charity. They got that love in action. And even if I disagree and don't want to be a Christian, they still love me. And they still care about me. And they weep over my soul. I remember my father-in-law when we were all outside sitting, sweating. And it was summer. My oldest daughter, she had a grandchild. And she went over there and my father-in-law was holding her. She said, you know, Grandpa, if you die, you're never going to see this baby again. And she said, why don't you come to church? And Reuben said, ma'am. He said, daughter, let me hold the baby again.
Oh, yes.
He just held her. And he began to weep. I never seen him weep. He started crying. She said, why don't you just come to church on Sundays, Grandpa? He said, I'll start coming. And let me say this. When he started coming, it didn't get better. Matter of fact, it got worse. One time, Brother Farley preached on hell. He walked out of that church saying, well, you heard that guy. I'm going to hell. I'm going, this is really helping. We just kept praying for him, kept on loving him. We didn't reject him. It went along. He got saved and his wife got saved. It takes charity. It takes a long time. Suffer the long time. That's what charity does. It suffers, it endures. It doesn't quit, doesn't give up on somebody. It just keeps on holding on, believing God is doing something in their life. I can't see it, but I know He's working deep down inside their soul. You gotta have your part. You gotta have charity. The only way you're gonna get it, you're gonna have to ask God, Lord, would you please give me charity? Because without it, I can't do anything. I can't witness. I can't do anything. Help me. Help me to get charity. Father, we love you. I pray, God, you'd help us. You'd touch the message. God, I pray for those that, Lord, are praying now, even asking, help me to get some charity. God, that you'd do that work. Lord, that you'd fill them with thy love and action. That they may be able to go out and do what charity requires of them. They'd continue loving despite everything in the world. They just keep loving and, Lord, showing Christ in their life. In Jesus' precious holy name, amen, amen.